Rated 13. Recommended for family viewing.
Of January 2020. That is the date this particular Wednesday morning, and a very good morning to you who's just joining us on yet another beautiful episode of Urban Today. It's going to be 2 hours of infotainment, and we definitely believe that you'll be catching us live right about now. And remember, later on we shall be live on Facebook as well as Twitter, so feel free to join the conversation. And at this point in time, I'd like to remind you this particular morning we'll be getting into some news that are making headlines as far as the Makere graduation ceremony is concerned. And I think man of the day for us was Hamza. I don't know about you, but this guy all along was a student. I didn't know, neither did anyone else know, including my CEO. Hey! But anyway, I'll be letting you know on how it all went down. And away from that, did you know that as a young person, spending a lot of time in church could not be good for you? This is coming in from one pastor here in town, and we'll be letting you know on who that person is. And away from that, we'll be getting into our usual, that is of course, shout-outs and kachai. Later on, we'll be having Nick joining us for sports. And before that, we'll be having our lovely little will be coming in at exactly the top of the hour, which will be 10 a.m. Good morning to you, and let's do this because it is Urban Today. Good morning to you guys.
Good morning.
Are you all right this morning?
I'm all right.
It's a Wednesday, and for some reason I feel like, you know, it should be a Thursday or, you know, a Friday. I don't know. I just feel like we need to get down this week and let it go. I don't know if it's just me.
Isn't it
like
the same guy who's been making noise for people who don't have some money?
No, that has nothing to do with
Sam Kamani. Well, the double standards.
What I'm trying to say is, I just need this week to get done, and, you know, we move on.
To
as
what?
Simple as that. To better things. You
like?
Know, I have things I'm looking forward to doing on the weekend. Things that are going to be, you know, financially earning. So that's why I'm looking forward to the weekend. That's why I need to get done with the weekdays, so that, you know, I get myself to the weekend. I don't know if that makes sense. It doesn't, yeah. That happens especially when you have nothing to look forward to during the weekend. But I'm sure, Willis, you have something you're looking forward to this weekend, don't you?
I always have something to look out to. You know, every day I wake up in the morning, you know, before I wake up, I have something to look out to during the day.
Hey.
Yeah, so...
So for the weekend?
There's a lot. There's a lot.
So you're looking forward to the weekend?
Yes, I'm looking
so forward. So the week should do, you know?
No.
Hey.
Today, I still have stuff to do today.
Hey.
I want the day to be, you know, a bit of 26 hours, 27 hours.
Hey, only?
Yes.
Okay.
Because I have a lot to do, so I want the day to be longer.
All right.
But unfortunately, it can't.
Tina Fierce, for you, what is your situation like?
Which situation? About what? You see, this is when I will tell you. Oh, I saw your mukul. What do gara we wala?
To get him on Zoom.
The eye of the ground, the black seas.
The black or the dirty part?
The black or the dirty?
What do gara? Yeah, the dirty part. No, you see, Kalimami Charibato, you're still doing those things. Simanyaka weekend, kachi. Fabamu, we know for a fact you don't have to be excited about just one weekend. Waking up every morning and making the money that you make, or just breathing in the air that you breathe, is good enough. I don't have to look forward to another day. The fact that I'm living this day here, I got the chance to live this one, that's my celebration. So when you get to my age, you'll understand the importance of that.
I don't think the world will still be revolving on that axis.
We will. Because it always comes back full circle. Aish, have you ever sat down with your parents telling you their stories of when they were in their prime? And then you're looking at them now and you're like, wait, was that the lit guy? And then you ask him, but you can still do it. You're still of age. You're still able-bodied. Now, gonna mwana wange.
Do you think if we started dressing like how our parents used to dress, we would still confuse these women?
Of course!
Really?
Any day, any time. Have you seen how
bell bottom, what kind of suit?
Lindako, have you seen how beautiful a man's butt looks in a nice fitting bell bottom? or in Levi jeans.
I have not seen it. No, I don't. Willis, have you seen it?
No.
Exactly. So clearly.
I don't usually look at going.
Particular things.
But I'll take some time off.
Hey, you want to venture?
I remember.
But definitely the girls would still get you. Because remember the days of our moms, it was always checkered short skirts, afro hair. Everything was shorter then. Everything was way shorter then. The girls used to wear short things, but it wasn't as perverted as it has turned into now. Because at times I look at the photos my grandmother has, and I'm like, wait, you mean you would walk in the square like that?
How about your grandmother was a slave queen?
No, she wasn't. She was regular from a very, very, very Catholic family. But even when you look at your auntie's photos or distant relatives, they were wearing shorter stuff.
Do you think Bagaya was, a slay queen?
Of course, for her time, she was the slay queen. Actually, Bagaya is Uganda's original slay queen. That is what it means to be a slay queen. You're not just a slay queen in Kampala. You're a slay queen with the JF Kennedys, with all the presidents. You're a slay queen dressing Vogue. You're a slay queen.
I think when you put the definition of slay queen the way we know it now.
Not now.
I don't think Eyaluri. I was a slay queen.
Eyaluri.
No.
See, Eyakati.
Eyakati. Original version.
Original version. And no, when you say to slay.
If you say Wagaya, Princess Wagaya was a slay queen then you're saying Princess Diana was a slay queen.
No.
They were not in the same era.
No, they were not in the same era, but you see the way they led their lives. They led their lives with that honor.
Let me tell you something. Princess Bagaya's life was so honorable. Honorable, we can't take it away. But you are...
But how do you say...
No, you're adulterating the word because you know its terminology now.
Exactly. That's what Willis is saying.
No!
It has never changed.
It was not there now.
We had the slay queens of those days.
Who's a slay queen? Let's first define a slay queen.
A slay queen is an... A slay queen is
the what?
Is the queen that you're slaying.
A slay queen is someone who has no job, but they somehow have a good look. You're
no.
That's a slay queen.
No. So did Bagaya have a job back then?
Yes, she had.
According to you, she had jobs. That
was
it.
A princess.
Let me tell you something. A slay queen is not just some girl who has long acrylic nails and doesn't have a job. There are very many slay queens who are actually employed, but when you see their character and in person, the things be about cola. Is what makes them a slay queen. If you're bad and bougie.
Are you a slay queen?
Who, me?
Yeah.
Hell no. I am too regular, it shocks me.
Really?
Yeah. So I'm not bougie.
You think you're regular?
Too regular.
Well, I think we just need to ask people what a slay queen is.
We need to find out what a slay queen
is. For me, when you say slay queen, it's Judith Hard, Bad Black.
But why?
That's slay queen for me.
Is Bad Black a slay queen? I feel like she's just too real.
No, Bad Black is just making her money.
Bad Black slay queen now.
Neda, Bad Black, Akola, she has a job.
I don't think Bad Black
she
is a
has a
queen.
Job. She wakes up every morning and she tells you, Zendi Malaya.
I think Bad Black is rather a hoe than a slay queen. Yeah, no offense.
You know what? Can we get back on script? Can we go back on script?
Is the former executive director of Kampala a slay queen?
Who?
No, she's not.
Jennifer?
Yes.
She's a slay judge, no?
She was a slay judge.
But so how do you say Jennifer Musisi is not a slay queen?
She's a slay judge.
That means she was a slay queen back in her time.
In her time.
No, she wasn't. But see, back in her time, she didn't have that Kamani.
Then she had the Kamani,
she would have been a slay queen.
Is the first lady a slay queen?
No.
Hell no, she
so how do you say the first lady is a slay queen, but Princess Bagaya?
No, the first lady is not a slay queen.
I'm looking at her, at how she's handled herself, and how she's moved with that honor with her. You know, when Bagaya moved
into once
place,
you're regal...
Everyone would respect her.
Listen,
would,
that's true. That's
listen,
true.
Like
an image.
Listen, once you're regal, you're regal. But then you also have to look at the other life she lived apart from being royalty. She was just a regular girl excited about being on magazine covers, going to Hollywood, living the life. No, it wasn't a job. It all came because of who she was. So she was just trying to have a good day.
I would want to, you know, look at the list.
And I believe the way Princess Bagaya is so open, I swear to God, if we called her and asked her, do you think you were slay queen in your time? She'll be like, hell yeah.
Yeah, she would say I was.
She would say she was.
But you see what?
I need to ask her.
I would want to look at the list and pictures of, you know, people that Bagaya dated. I would like to, you know, find out.
Yo, her profile is too big.
Why did you say people?
That profile is too big.
She might have had only one person.
That's a lie. She's about what, 80 years of age now?
I don't
know. And she's still looking beautiful.
Imagine in her 20s, 30s, 40s.
Sheena, do you remember what that girl looked like when she was Sheena?
Is the princess of Buganda. Like,
that's which one? Which one?
No,
the queen of Buganda.
The queen?
I mean, the same
place. Now, man, you took a script.
She's not.
To duck a script.
I think she's in the same.
She's regal.
She's in the same bracket with Kadaga.
They are regal. No, not slave. No.
They are just more.
Flash is a real queen.
If I should be, you know.
Kadaga is a land friend.
They're respectable elders.
She's a council.
I don't know why that didn't
they're
come out.
They're respectable elders. You see how the Shaolin have monks. So those are the monks now.
The senseis.
The senseis.
So many people who you can. Oh, is Honorable Betty coming as Slay Queen?
Can we get back on script?
I want to celebrate truck drivers this morning. If you're a very disciplined truck driver, I'd like to celebrate you this morning. There's no amount of pressure that can, you know, be compared to the pressure you have when you're driving in front of a truck. You know, maguru kuminge kulima vigawanai. All the time you're looking in the side mirror thinking, okay, I hope the brakes of that thing don't break. But, you know, I'd like to celebrate those guys who keep it real and drive properly on the roads. And this morning, Dubawadi, Mukolomri Mugwamani, if I was the one driving a truck, I'd probably be bullying everyone off the road.
And because you're short.
Yeah.
It's Wednesday because keep quiet. You can't even climb the truck.
Hey.
As in, since it's Wednesday, don't you happen there? Can I wait to deck script? It's Wednesday. Which females are you celebrating?
I want to celebrate with climbing the rig truck.
Okay.
I'm not a woman.
Banange. Nzamunde can send in
the shout out. I look good, but I'm not a woman. Like,
can I send my shout outs? It's Wednesday. Uh-huh. So this Wednesday, I would like to send major shout outs and to all those women who understand that this 2020, all you have to do is go out there, make your money to avoid having very unnecessary sex this year.
Yeah.
Very
many women have been caught up in that mix of you don't have transport back home from a bank.
And then you have to give some.
Boom, you have to give some.
No, just make you some money.
The landlord is demanding like 6 months, then boom.
The kids need fees.
This is what I have to offer.
Yeah, just go look for some kamane mwekolerekeza mwe. You will avoid very unnecessary sex in this 2020. But jabba
uvales. Okay. All right. Talking about some kamane. We have graduates from Makerere University who did, of course, make it yesterday after that whole chaos of guns and whatnot. Finally, the D-Day came to happen, and people got, you know, their bachelor's degrees, their master's, their PhDs, and just people are graduating, and it was a good function, full of smiles, people moving with their siblings, not
their sisters.
That they are their siblings, but they are sisters. So it was interesting. We do have, of course, some interesting pictorials coming in from that particular place. And our team that was on ground managed to get in touch with Hamza, who was also a graduate yesterday at Makerere University. And this is what he had to say.
I put professional ahead of everything.
Rema's husband to be right there, of course, by the names of Hamza, graduating in a bachelor's degree in human medicine and bachelor's degree in surgery. Talking about a couple of challenges that they do face, but congratulations to him and a couple of thousands that did make it to this particular day as far as day one of Makerere University's 70th graduation ceremony is concerned. I don't know, what do you guys think? I mean, he made it.
Yeah. Mm. I mean, what did we expect? He was going to make it. Kinda.
Yeah. But did you know that he was actually a student?
Yeah.
Honestly speaking.
Yeah, because because medicine takes how many years here? It's 7?
I don't know.
It's 5.
No.
It's 5.
No.
8.
Because you do the 4, then after the 4, if you're going to specialize, you do another 3.
No. Yeah. Why are we arguing? None of us has studied medicine.
Don't worry, Google it in Uganda, because in other countries it's 11 years. Yes, we... Personally, I knew it.
I thought lawyers study the most.
No,
lawyers are 5 years or 4 years.
It's medicine.
Mm. Lawyers are 4 years at the university.
Yes.
Then you have over 2 years at LDC.
1 year.
LDC is 9 months.
1 year. Yeah. Yes. Just to pass on my new name.
I tell LDC to agaraji jao.
Why? Huh? Wait, did you just...
Tamumbu Zavinji. What? So get it at LDC. But you see, he graduated and is telling you that there are challenges at work.
Yes.
Yeah.
And, you know, one of the challenges in his line of duty is that you have to work on women. Mm. And I don't know, he faced the challenge.
Do you think if you were doing his kind of work, do you think working on women would be a challenge?
No, I'm very professional, by the way. Yeah, most people say that journalists are womanizers and whatnot. Mm-hmm. I'm not for one. I don't know if you are. I hope you're not, and I pray you're not.
No, I am not one. But let me just clear the air and proceed.
But, you know, doing his line, in his line of duty, he's faced with many challenges. You know, a gynecologist and... I remember just recently when I had a baby, the guy who was working on our case was a guy.
Mm. And, you know, on the other side?
Yeah, looking at his... No, everywhere. Hey. You're allowed to go everywhere as a, even
yeah, as an obstetrician.
So it's a tricky job, I'm telling you.
That's right.
I honestly don't think it is, because as a woman, I've spent pretty much my entire adult life going to see a gynecologist. Mm. Like you said, all it takes is professionalism. Because Linda Komkwan, or yourself, when you're cutting, his last 3 patients he checked out 2 days ago. Bafana nabatia tabajukira. Because for them, listen, no. Because for them, no, listen. Because for them, they are not looking at your anatomy in that way. They are looking at you that way an engineer would look at.
A road.
Watch the game exam. All the way a mechanic would look at the full engine. Ochitegera.
Olienga ya mujukira.
Kubabo basusa wo.
You know what is making me understand?
There are people in Kampala, by the way, and let's not take it for granted, that do these kinds of jobs that actually, doing all sorts of things to women.
Mm. Yeah, true.
And they go past it. Nataniko kugamba yu wano utukwazi chika kunyigemu wano.
Ochitegera.
Oliyota wenyigano wenkwata wano. So, I mean, there are challenges they face, and I hope he's not faced with another challenge.
It's very sad that we have very few, you know, gynecologists in here in the country. And at this point in time, every time I think about women that have died while giving birth, it gives me a reason to go back and study master's in gynecology.
You're still young, you can still go.
I should be a gynecologist.
But those hands.
Yeah. Shape them properly.
You have been in me.
You see, this is when I ask. This is when I call upon. I want to call upon the Ministry of Health to make sure you really vet the people you're going to let do certain things.
Let's get into more sad news coming in. Now, of course, I talked about a pastor who has warned youth against spending time a lot in church. Now, Bishop Elijah Sebuchu, a senior pastor at the Kampala International Christian Center in Chanja, Kampala, urged the youth to work very hard in order to fight poverty. He said spending the whole day in church and not working will not yield much. For one to survive in this world, they have to work. My advice to the youth is that you start up small businesses, trust in God, and desert from practices such as corruption, theft, and other vices that can ruin your future. Mm. I think this is just...
This is the best message of 2020. This, like, we shouldn't even exceed this. We don't deserve this. Mm. We have sung this countless times. I have been like the biggest advocate for the youth that actually just wake up and think just walking and putting your prayers with the Lord is going to uplift your life in ways unimaginable, because these pastors, all they do is give these people too much hope. You go on Monday, it's like akati encha tugenda tugenda kusiba 40 nova ku 40 na kugamba kati tugenda kusiga nsigo,
and they have a sort of mind control tendency that they use to people. They go to church on Sunday and say tomorrow tugenda sawira gwanga, after lunch to be the midday service in the evening.
Atenga wona musonda
kumachatu ina morning glory. I think this guy should be the head of all born again churches in
Thank
Uganda
you.
With this message.
Thank
you. Bishop Elijah. Should have his image put at the Constitutional Square with his message there.
Just this color in
me. And allow him to contest for the president of this country.
Thank I think you. Finally, I'm now you could agree with me that we have officially started 2020.
Official.
Yeah. We have the statement for the year. Let's get into some starting news. Now, yesterday we were talking about a program that is being, of course, run together with Vision Group as far as Live Your Dream is concerned. That is the name of this particular campaign. UNFPA, together with Vision Group, they're trying to sensitize the girl child and make sure that they're looking at all reasons that lead to teenage pregnancies and how do we fight these reasons. And at the end of the day, how do we keep a girl child in school? We have another video this morning that we would like to share with you to send this message back home.
Kubanga kati omwana oyo akyali muto. Era nze gy'olaba nze nkaaba amaziga. Kubanga singa nasomako ku lulumi lwange ku myaka egyo. Singa kati oba ndi musomesa, oba ndi kiki, oba ndi kiki, simanyi. Neera ntuula wali ne nkaaba ne ngamba nti taata lwaki tuwamperera ne tusoma baana. Twali abawala batya bana naye lwaki tiyatuweererera. Naye abaana abo. Tebatula naffe ffe abazadde. Ne kitaawe wamugamba nti musitense ere mu center togenda. Era yebba wano n'agenda mu center 4:45. Oyo omwana omuto akola ki mu center. Kye kireetedde abaana baffe okuleeta ki embuto. Yadde balenzi nadde bawala. Kake kireetedde abaana butatuulira ffe abazadde. Singa kati ndina abazzukulu oba bameka oba bameka. Neteri muzzukulu ajja n'atuula nga bw'otudde awo n'omugamba nti ffe omulembe gwaffe tetwazanyanga nga mwe muzanya. Tetwakolanga bino lwaki totuula wano. Gendako mu nnyumba ofumbe naye kupalapala kale kye kireetedde abaana okola ki okwonooneka. Singa abawala bakkiriza okubeera ne bataata baabwe ne bamaama baabwe ne babeera wamu bandibadde bakendezaako omulimu ogwo ate ne baana bannaffu abo abakazi mukaaga muntu omu basatu babiri kakye kireeta obuzibu obwo taata tasobola kukola ki tasobola kukola kiki ekyo abazadde nabo kati n'omugamba nti mwanyi naze omukono gwoki mumpi lwaki tobeera na mukazi ono omu eyazaala abaana.
There you have it, of course, a message coming in from an elder right there. And we do hope that by the end of this campaign, we can be able to keep the young girl in school and, of course, avoid teenage pregnancies, as they seem to be the biggest reason as to how we have the highest number of school dropouts. Now, moving away from that, we want to take a quick look at more starting news coming in. Now, apparently, man kills relative in a 2,000 shilling fight. Andrew Onono, a 32-year-old resident of Ateke Village in Apaksab County, who is on the run, is said to have stabbed his cousin, identified as Moses Ongu Jogo, 38 years of age, three times on the neck using a kitchen knife on Monday evening after a fight erupted between them. Joel Omunu, an eyewitness, said Ongu Jogo of Oima Njira clan gave 2,000 shillings to Onono to hire his smartphone to use for a day. However, trouble started when the phone in question failed to work. The deceased is said to have demanded for the refund of his money, but the brother refused, leading to a fight that cost his life. The incident comes barely a week after Jimmy Okabo, a resident of Olimu sub-county of Teke district, was stabbed to death over 300 shillings. Okabo was reportedly stabbed from the back by his friend, only identified as Okelo Oje, while struggling for the money won in a game of gambling in Yedel Division, Lira Municipality. An eyewitness, James Obaro, said Okabo and Okelo Oje were playing cards and the former was supposed to be paid 300 shillings by Okelo, who refused to give him the money, leading to a fight. Okabo, however, died on arrival to Rila Regional Referral Hospital when attempts to save his life failed, while the suspect has since fled and his whereabouts remain unknown.
Unemployment, depression,
social
media.
Is it poverty? What is it?
We don't know anymore.
But it sparks off, you know.
But you see, when you go back to the principle, the principle, pay your debt. It doesn't matter how small the debt is. Anyway,
like at Veya, to get a cop because Mushara out in Dara is making a headlines at this particular morning. Now, apparently, my shout out is going into the State Minister of Foreign Affairs, Henry Okello Oryem. He made headlines yesterday, and according to the State Minister for Foreign Affairs, Henry Okello Oryem, bad roads can be part of tourism experience for people hailing from different parts of the country or even other countries. Leading a team of technocrats from the Ministry of Foreign Affairs during their interference with lawmakers sitting on the Foreign Affairs Committee earlier yesterday, Oryem said that the damage done on the roads by recent prolonged rains ought not to be a cause for concern. The technocrats were at the parliament to answer queries relating to next year's budget framework paper. For us, a bad road is cause for complaining, but for the people in societies who have never experienced getting stuck in a bad road, pushing a car from a ditch can be part of tourism experience, Oryem said. Oryem was responding to MPs' queries as to whether poor roads in Uganda are partly responsible for the country receiving fewer tourists compared to countries like Kenya and Tanzania. Oryem noted that despite Uganda not receiving as many tourists as the other countries in the region, it continues raving reviews globally.
No, what, eh?
But how?
No, don't. Calm down.
So in,
first,
in
no,
the,
first
no,
breathe.
No.
Njagalo se. Sir. Katifulumi.
In the minister's head.
Mm-hmm. Infinite wisdom.
Someone in Europe.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Is Googling and saying, I want to visit places with very bad roads.
Yes.
And he Googles and Uganda comes up and he's saying, I'm going to Uganda
to
pay
car.
My money, pay for a tourist visa, get a tourist guide, and go
to
and tour bad roads.
Yes.
Like that is money that we should expect from tourism
yes.
because we have bad roads.
Yes. That is what he's saying.
Are we together?
And he's saying that it could be an experience, even for you, who is coming in from Kololo.
Yes.
When you go to whatever, whichever village you're going to, and you have to push your car, it gives you experience. Like you put it on your CV. That is what, according to him, this whole thing means.
Ay, Willis, why
so
do
we
you
need
know?
People to apply for jobs as
to
tourist guides
roads.
To say, I
on
know
potholes.
All the roads.
I know all the potholes.
All the potholes.
Yes.
And where they are located.
Exactly.
And you're a tourist guide.
Yes.
Yes. We're job creator.
So let me ask.
Museven, how is this one still our state minister?
Very much so.
Foreign affairs.
Maybe we misunderstood what you were saying.
No,
about.
Honey.
Did
we didn't. Willis.
Poor. I want to
understand.
I want this message.
Like,
I want his message.
Regardless of how you want your mind to take it in, it is the way it has been.
I want this message to sound the way it's actually sounded.
Okay.
Let's take it.
Jogere.
Now, the bad roads could actually be. Okay, no.
Are going to be.
People. Come, how can I say it? Njogere ntia. Nti, engude mbi. Zibazi gendo kola. Tourist attraction.
Is a good embi.
Again, look, Janga, good embi.
So let's just collect all the poor people, put them in one place, cage them up, and make a zoo.
Exactly.
Like, poverty should be a tourist attraction.
I know, right? Like, what do you think the best part would be? I think we should turn our national zoo into a poverty zoo.
But
talking
about bad roads, which area in Kampala would be, like, full of tourists because of bad roads?
Najera.
Najera has bad roads.
Najera
is only one car road.
Kulambiro on a rainy day. On a rainy day.
Just one car road.
All through from Kulambiro or Echkutwala no gwe Najera, Echkutwala no weyongida egayat.
Chochimutsi nitachinza later tourist money.
Gwe, mfufu ya Kulambiro.
It means the road.
From Entebbe Road.
No salamu emachi indi, no dekabalagala. Nove kabalagala neetola bwete muyengo de
ku olaba ngagwe bokoze sente
banange
olaba saketi
get one tourist like this
no muzunza
aya toli takuvuma nga tolinge kubolye najela
abakuwe mudde
oboli naro oboli yao nga tutegerekeka oina potholes side ne side kwa gamboli yao yuwajize
obubala bunji
obere najela ngo vugo jamu chibugo linga ba mu chibuga ne mtoka ne mvamo motoka mzee
gwaba weta
kasokewa wano boti.
Let's get into some more shout-outs to the face.
Oh my Jesus. Anyway, Nzu Yamasaba officials. Now, Nzu Yamasaba officials have directed security in Mbale and Bugisu at large to arrest whoever will go practicing forceful circumcision on other tribes. Now, the directive was sounded recently by Deputy Prime Minister and Head of Protocol Nzu Yamasaba Cultural Institution. That is, of course, Mathias Nabutere. The directive comes after over 5 people have been forcefully circumcised in Mbale town since the beginning of the year. The organized group of energetic youths targets mainly border riders and businessmen from other surrounding tribes that enter Mbale to carry out businesses. The group that forces uncircumcised men into circumcision claim they are trying to keep Mbale clean. In 2016 and 2018, scores of non-Bamasaba was attacked by a group of people who claimed to be Bamasaba and forcefully circumcised them, while others looted their property, causing a security threat in town.
There was a member of parliament, I think 5 or 6 years ago, who was
circumcised by force.
In the city. They looked for the guy. Anyway, my shout out is going to CSOs, and that's civil society organizations. Why? Because in Chigezi sub-region, they've asked the government to ensure a balanced political platform for all players to enable fair leadership choices in the forthcoming elections. Uganda is scheduled to have its general elections in 2021, and most politicians are using this year to lay ground for their ambitions. However, some leaders of CSOs in Chigezi have said the current political standards in the country portray a clear image of unbalanced grounds. Robert Karuru, the executive director of Kick Corruption Out of Uganda, a local non-government organization in the area, said that suppression that was exhibited on Monday as Robert Chagulanyi, alias Bobi Wine, and Chadono East legislator launched his consultations for presidency were a signal of an intolerant system. According to Fred Enanga, the police spokesperson, they have noticed continuous violation of Public Order Management Act, where politicians hold illegal political meetings in their respective homes and those of their allies. Enanga said commanders in various areas must ensure that any meeting involving more than 3 people is policed in accordance with the provisions of the POMA, or else such gatherings should not be allowed to happen. Very interesting conversation. The CSO asking for something that clearly can't happen and might never
not
happen
anytime soon.
Century to have, you know, a leveled ground. Even the USA,
it's never leveled.
So it's never leveled. But I think that, you know, their call is important. That let's strive at least to to have a little bit of balance. Fairness.
I'm going to say something before we wrap up, but I'm saying it on behalf of a friend. Thank God Enanga has come out to be very clear that a meeting should only, you know, by the time you have to involve the police, it should be of three people and above. So that means just two people, it is okay. So those of you who are asking us for consent letters from the police when people invite you to their homes, please, now you've heard. If it is two people, you don't need a letter.
Right. Do we have a police?
We are three here. Do we have a police letter?
Which one? This one, yeah, we have.
You're sure?
The police knows we are alive.
Yeah.
So it is aware.
Sure.
Yeah. But if it is just
and
the
we
two
have
of
police
us,
policing around.
Yeah. If it is just the two of us and I'm telling you to come over, we don't need the police.
Set us is a Tina. Ngabali abantu batano mukaga bali waka.
Bali waka.
I know.
And you see bamwe.
Why? Can't get out of this
management act. But let's get into a very short break. When we do get back, we want to find out what is making headlines in today's dailies. We'll begin it off with the new vision immediately after this.